私の一番好きな感じは多分希望の感じ。
Hi, I'm Alice and I'm a first year. Nice to meet you. I've always known that I wanted to study a language at university, and initially, I mean, when I was like 12 or 13, I really wanted to do French and German, but what made me really want to study Japanese was a combination of the fact that I've always loved Japanese film, and that interest got much deeper when I was in, I think, year 10. Many people can relate to this, but I love the Studio Ghibli films. My favourite one is probably... Oh, that's a really hard question. Laputa, Castle in the Sky. If not that, then Nausicaa, Valley of the Wind. This is my bed, which I love. I'm very happy to have a double bed. Bedside tables, I have my chest of drawers too. This is my wardrobe, which is, you know, useful. You can keep anything in there that you need. You can keep stuff in there over the holidays as well, which is very useful. Yeah, bookshelves. Behind you is my desk. So you can keep loads of stuff in your drawers here.
Hey, can I see your bathroom?
Sure. If you do have a bathroom in your room, it will always have a shower and a toilet. I love manga. I've always liked reading it since I was probably like 10. So when I went back to Japan this year, I finally got to get some in Japanese. So I have quite a wide range of stuff. So yeah, obviously Japanese at Cambridge is an ab initio course. You can start completely from scratch. There's no prior knowledge assumed or required, but my personal situation is such that I've been doing it for, well, I guess this is my sixth year. I started when I was 14. So yeah, I've been doing it for quite a long time now, and I took the GCSE, but I did that a year late, so I followed the A-level course, didn't take the exam in the end, did not have the time, needless to say. But then I also took a gap year where I lived in Japan for 6 months, so I don't need to take a lot of the first year classes. I can have personal supervisions or follow, I'm auditing one of the second year modules as well. So instead of, say, attending grammar lessons or conversation lessons, which will usually be in groups, I have a one-to-one session with a teacher where I'm only speaking in Japanese and I'm doing worksheets or just bits of work from other textbooks. I am attending sessions and I'm expected to prepare for them, so I do all the reading, but I don't need to do the essays or the exam at the end of the year. So it's literally just extension work, basically. I'm auditing J9, which is the same class, which is very interesting.
Nice. 日本で何してきたんですか？その6ヶ月間とか日本にいた。
池袋の近くに住んでて、モデルとして働いていました。中板橋っていう本当に小さな近所に住んでいました。東武東上線のもう駅ですね。Right now, what do I do? I love video games, so I play them quite a lot. Although I do have to do quite a lot of reading for my course, I do like reading fiction too, and obviously I have my collection of manga over there, so I'm trying to work through that. One of the other students of Japanese in first year is just down the corridor from me, so we hang out together quite often. It's called Charlie.
Oh, Charlie.
I'm friends with lots of the Chinese students too, so we went ice skating today, had lunch at Wetherspoon. There are various accommodation bands. They start at, I think they go down to as low as 7, and they go all the way up to 1 with a star. This Howard Lodge is 1. When you're applying, well, no, once you've got your offer and you've met your grades, you'll have a sort of accommodation form to fill in, and you get 3 choices for which bands you want to be in. I just picked 3, 2, 1. I think band 1 here is £194 a week, and then the only band that's higher than that, band 1 star, I think is about 200 a week, band 2 is 180 something, and band 3 is 170 something. So it goes down by approximately £10 each band. little fridge there, two bigger ones there. We have freezers too. Got a toaster. Hobs. We have a grill and we have an oven too.
Wow.
And got a microwave. And we all the cupboards with numbers on there, lockable cupboards. There's a lot of spices. I love cooking, so got lots of extra things. I guess when it comes to studying, there are quite a few options. Your college will always have a library, so you can study there. I personally find studying in the library a bit weird because the feeling of having everyone around you can be a bit stressful. It's like, oh, I have to work. So I use my desk a lot. So that's just got my computer, some notes on. And you know what? I'm quite bad. I study on my bed too. It's not supposed to be very good for your sleep patterns if you study on your bed, but we're all guilty of not doing everything perfectly sometimes.